lot, Dave. Thanks. Well, this week's storm has skiers and snowboarders getting excited for the upcoming season. Here's a live picture tonight, but even with our first burst of snow, the slopes need some support. Again, this is a live look at Buck Hill, where they're using some new technology now to make that snow. Our Ellen McNamara is here with a look at what makes these new snow guns so special, Ellen.
Bill, it's nothing really new for ski slopes to get some new snow guns, but this year Buck Hill has an edge. It means the snowmaking process is a lot easier on everyone. And today workers got their hand on them for the first time. At first glance, there's nothing extraordinary about these snow guns. But ask anyone at Buck Hill, and they'll tell you, they're bringing skiing and snowboarding to a completely different level.
You can really fine-tune to the air temperature and the humidity to make sure you get a good frozen flake when it hits the ground. That's the key there.
It makes a phenomenal snow quality, which in turn makes for some fun snowboarding.
So what makes these snow guns unique? They aren't operated by humans or machine. They're operated by Bluetooth.
I can see the water pressure at that specific gun, the relative humidity, the wet bulb temperature, and the water temperature.
And they come from Italy and Sweden to right here in Burnsville. These foreign guns are also saving workers a lot of time and labor.
I don't have to spend as much time with each snow gun to start it up or to make adjustments.
And Buck Hill skiers aren't the only ones benefiting. Zombie Board Shop, just down the road, is also supported.
The more people that are riding at Buck Hill, the more people that are stopping through here and, you know, supporting local business.
And Buck Hill bought a total of 3 snow guns. They're really not cheap, though. They cost about $40,000. For people who enjoy Buck Hill, though, the good news is that ticket prices will not be affected. The hills should be open on Friday. We have a full list of ticket prices uploaded to our website, kstp.com. Just click on the news tab to find them. Bill.
All right, looks like a lot of fun, Ellen. Thanks. Opening day is not far off for other ski resorts in our area. Wild Mountain in Taylor's Falls and Trollhagen in Dresser, Wisconsin are already open. Welch Village, just south of Hastings, tells us they may open as early as Friday afternoon. And Afton Alps, near Hastings as well, a little north of Hastings, says they should know by Thursday when they'll open. Go to the links page at kstp.com. You can check on ski conditions and find a list of other winter recreation spots.